welcome to our channel, Agricultural Crop Production. So this afternoon, I am going to impart with you on the job of the farmer. One of the job or the work of the farmer is to maintain the crop. In maintaining the crop, so it is very necessary that you know how to control or to suppress the weed growth of the area. Not only that, it is also very necessary that we are going to protect our crops from the attack of pests and diseases so that we can assure to have good production. And one of the tools, this is very important for controlling the weeds as well as the protection of our crop, is the knapsack sprayer. So, knapsack sprayer is used in applying chemical for weeding. So if you are going to adopt the chemical method of weeding, so we are going to use the herbicides, then we are going to apply that one using the knapsack sprayer. Another is by spraying our crops with insecticides or fungicide to have the protection for their growth and development. So if you are going to use knapsack sprayer, it is very important that we also know what are the different parts of the knapsack sprayer. For sure, it is very important to a farmer to know how to dismantle and to assemble a knapsack sprayer. So a knapsack sprayer has different parts. So of course, we have the so-called external part. So as a whole, this is now the so-called knapsack sprayer tank. Then this one, this is the carry handle. Then of course, this one is the back strap. Then of course, this is the back strap holder. This one that surrounds our knapsack sprayer is the spill guard. Then of course, this one is the so-called operating lever. Then our operating lever has two functions, the upstroke and the downstroke. Then we also have the hose to lance and the lance. So in dismantling this one, we are going to follow the principle. And the principle is that the first part to be removed is the last part to be returned. So I am going to start now dismantling our knapsack sprayer. And at the same time, I will be identifying the parts of the knapsack sprayer. So, this one now. Okay, so this part is the hose to lance. So this is the hose to lance, and hose to lance to connect that into the lance. So we have the trigger, operating trigger. So this one is the operating trigger. Then of course, this is the lance. Then at the tip of the lance is now the nozzle. So we have also different type of nozzle. We have the single cone nozzle and the double cone nozzle. Then after that one, so I have to remove the back strap. So these are the back strap to be removed. So the function of this back strap is to be placed on the back of the operator. Then I am going to remove now the refilling cap. So this is our refilling cup. Then next is now the strainer. So this is the strainer. Then of course, I am going to remove now the pump assembly. To remove this one, so we are going to use the Allen wrench. So this is now the Allen wrench. So in removing all the bolt, so see to it that you are going to remove that in X style. One. So try to loosen it using our Allen wrench. And after that, as I told you, remove the bolt X by X. And the other one. So that is now the Allen wrench. So I am going to remove now the pump assembly. So for the pump assembly, so there are similar parts of this. So this is now our gasket. Then I have to remove the pin lock. Okay, so this is the operating lever. So as the whole, this is now the pump assembly, which composed of the operating lever. Then this is the pressure chamber, and the other one is the piston chamber. Inside the pressure chamber is the dip tube. So this is our dip tube. Then to lock the dip tube, so we have the star lock. Then of course, inside the piston chamber, so found the piston assembly. And we have to remove the piston assembly. Okay, so this is now the piston assembly with different parts. So again, this is the piston chamber. Inside the piston chamber is the piston assembly. So the parts of the piston assembly, so we have the gasket. Then we also have the return spring. And this is now the piston rod. Then below the piston chamber is now the foot valve stand. Inside the foot valve stand is now the inlet ball valve. Then the screen that covered to our foot valve stand is now the filter. Para ang function niya is to filter the chemical. Then of course, we also have the so-called access valve nut. Inside here is now the so-called outlet ball valve. Then of course, this is the so-called pump assembly hole. So this is the pump assembly hole, and this is the refilling hole. So those are now the different parts of the knapsack sprayer. Again, so this is the knapsack tank. This is the carry handle. So this is the pump assembly hole, and this is the refilling hole. Then of course, this is the back strap holder. So this is the foot valve stand, wherein we are going to place this one on the piston chamber. So I am going to return this one now. So piston on the piston chamber. Inside the piston chamber is now the piston assembly. So return the piston assembly. So we have to lock this one. Then after that, so I am going to return now the pip tube to be returned inside the pressure chamber. Symbol the swan, the operating lever again. So all of this is now the pump assembly. So I am going to return first this one before I am going to connect the operating lever. So do not forget to insert the gasket. So this is now our gasket. So we are going to place now the pump assembly on the pump assembly hole. Then after that, we are going to return the nut. type in this one. So we are going to use the onion rings. I am now returning the operating lever. Okay, then after that, so place the okay, so yeah, so we already assembled the operating lever. So I am going to return the strainer. After the strainer, of course, the refilling cap. Then, of course, I am going to connect the box strap. Okay, that's it. After this one, so of course, I am going to return the outlet hose to latch. This is our outlet hose to latch. After connecting the outlet hose to latch, so the operating lever or the trigger. After this one, so the lamps. And of course, the last one is now the nozzle. So, the nozzle. Then once it is already assembled, so the next thing we are going to do is to test whether it is functional or not. After that, so we are going to test. So, this is functional. So again, this is how you are going to dismantle and assemble in a suck sprayer. So why it is very important that we must know how to dismantle, how to assemble in a knapsack sprayer so that we can also perform simple troubleshooting of our knapsack sprayer. And we can only know how to troubleshoot our knapsack sprayer if we also know what are the different parts of our knapsack sprayer. So, Knapsack sprayer is very important in doing the maintenance of our crop. So remember, prevention of the crop is better than cure. And thank you very much. And please subscribe our channel, Agricultural Crop Production. Good day.